The cost of housing in Florida is presenting a big challenge to companies looking to attract workers. Look at this consumer price index by FGCU for the Tampa area. You can see in 2022, we all know this, prices spiked. It hasn't been as bad this year, but still really high. NBC2's Ashley Graham found a business in Bonita Springs that's now getting creative.
The demand for workers is rising as a busy tourist season gets closer. Instead of branching out to find housing for their workers, the Bonita Bay Club wants to look inward.
We're hoping that it's a small and just one type of solution for the ongoing problem that we have, not just in the local area, but throughout the state, for affordable housing close by places of work.
If the project goes through with the city, this building would house about 40 workers here at the Bonita Bay Club, which would go a long way in providing somewhere to stay for workers who might not otherwise be able to afford to live here.
It's a drop in the bucket for an issue that workers all over Lee County are facing.
Our CNAs, our nurses, our police officers, our staff in restaurants and, you know, in retail. Where are they living, you know, and how are we helping, you know, have a number of units available for different income levels?
Affordable housing is an issue.
Jesse Purden with the Bonita Springs City Council says helping people live closer to where they work is vital.
So if you're going to get people to work for you, it has to be something that makes sense for them. And this will be able to allow them to offer perks that will allow them to get the people that they need on a regular basis.
The Bonita Bay Club is working with the city to get the building zoned to allow employee housing.
Initially, it came to us as a request, and they're not zoned for this. That's just the reality. They didn't agree with that. We kind of went back and forth about it. But at the end of the day, I think we're amenable to this being voted on as a change in the zoning to allow it to happen. It's just that it has to follow the appropriate process and procedures.
A 2018 report from the Florida Housing Coalition showed that affordable housing for workers was already getting harder to find in Lee County. Lee County published another study in 2007 with the same conclusion. Marcia Davis with the Fort Myers Housing Authority says the problem is only getting worse as time goes on.
I think the affordable housing shortage has been, you know, for a very long time, and I think the hurricane, you know, exacerbated, and then the market has exacerbated the issues.
We had to come up with different solutions, as you mentioned, one of which was creating a stipend for people to be able to take an Uber or ride-sharing service to and from work.
For years, finding housing was just one part of the issue for these workers. Even with those stipends, they had to travel from as far north as Fort Myers to as far south as Naples. It's the only way they could find places that they could afford to live.
All over Lee County, the demand for workforce, affordable, and attainable housing is high.
I have a waiting list of probably 7,000 to 10,000 people. With, you know, no units available. We have 90 units that are coming out of the ground now that we're starting to lease up that there's already waiting lists for. So as we build it, we need like 10 more of those, like right up in the pipeline.
If everything goes to plan, Bonita Bay Club workers could start living here in 2025. Davis says the gap between housing supply and demand will take years to fill. Money from Hurricane Ian recovery will be a key part of closing that gap.
I think where the bulk of the recovery money is allocated is to housing, and which is needed. The units that we lost from the hurricane and then the lack of units that we needed before the hurricane.
Reporting in Lee County for NBC2, I'm Ashley Graham.